The evolutionary journey of these creatures spans a relatively short 20 million years ago, marked by intriguing morphological and physiological adaptations. But why are they so distinct among the animals of the African savanna? In this video, we'll delve into the taxonomy, evolutionary history, anatomical features, and ecological significance of giraffes, examining their unique fighting styles, the sounds they make, and the challenges of giving birth as a 6-meter giant. Giraffes are a bizarre genus of even-toed ungulate, the order that includes many of the familiar herbivores such as cows, camels, deer, and pigs. The ruminant family Giraffidae was once far more diverse, but now contains two genera, the strange-looking okapi from Congo, and at least 3 to 8 species of giraffe. Their taxonomy is a matter of debate, with some claiming all giraffes are simply subspecies of Giraffe camelopardalis and others asserting that 4 or more of these are separate species. The giraffe is the tallest land mammal on the planet. Fossils suggest they arrived relatively recently, around 20 million years ago, from ancestors that were likely more deer-like in appearance. Giraffe necks grew longer, in part, as a result of sexual selection for better fighters, as males compete for females using these muscular structures to swing their heads at one another. Longer necks opened up to new resources higher up in the branches, and secondary selective forces worked to transform giraffes into the immense, gangly animals we see today. And this neck is exceptional among extant animals. While the dinosaur era saw the rise of the longest necks in the animal kingdom, some up to 15 meters or 50 foot long, modern animals have much reduced necks, and extremes like the giraffe are far less common. This neck holds the brain of the giraffe so high off the ground and so far from its heart that giraffes need a special circulatory system to maintain oxygen levels in their heads. Now, only deoxygenated blood has to be forced all the way up there. When the giraffe lowers its head to drink, it needs to prevent the same blood from rushing into its head with force. This is achieved by a series of powerful valves along the length of the blood vessels. But it's not only blood that needs to be regulated. As a ruminant, the giraffe needs to bring food up from the stomach for a second round of chewing. This is done by extremely strong muscles in the esophagus, and the immense forces it provides can regurgitate food from all the way down in the stomach back to the mouth. These necks are great for reaching tall branches, but they're even more impressive when used as a weapon. Bull giraffes engage in dominance displays in which they push each other around, whipping their heads at one another in a competition known as necking. Most of these interactions are not harmless, but some can be lethal. On top of the giraffe's head are a pair of bony protrusions called ossicones. These can inflict some serious damage during a violent battle, and two giraffes fighting can sometimes become a bloody affair. And this is no mean feat, as these remarkable creatures stand at a height of 4 to 6 meters, or 13 to 20 feet. In terms of weight, adult giraffes vary widely, with males weighing between 1,100 to 1,800 kilograms, 2,400 and 4,000 pounds, and females ranging from 700 to 1,200 kilograms, 1,500 to 2,600 pounds. Giraffes are native to the African continent and primarily inhabit savannas, grasslands, and open woodlands. These relatively gentle giants are well adapted to diverse ecosystems, ranging from semi-arid regions to more lush subtropical landscapes. They can be found in numerous countries throughout sub-Saharan Africa, such as Kenya, Tanzania, South Africa. Within these habitats, giraffes demonstrate a preference for areas with acacia trees, a key component of their diet. Their long necks and specialized tongues allow giraffes to reach the leaves of all trees, providing them with a feeling of advantage in these habitats. Giraffe tongues are extraordinary feats of evolutionary design. Prehensile, thick, and leathery, coated with a dense protective saliva and a dark pigment that shields them from the African sun. These tongues can grow up to 45 centimeters or 18 inches long, enabling giraffes to access foliage high up in the trees that other herbivores cannot reach, plucking it from between acacia thorns. As mentioned earlier, giraffes are ruminants, possessing a complex stomach with four compartments that aid in the digestion of tough plant materials. Giraffes exhibit a broad palate, feeding on 90% of tree species on the savanna, but acacia and cambretum species make up approximately half of their diet. In the wild, giraffes generally live between 15 to 25 years. However, reaching these maximum ages is often challenging due to the various risks they face throughout their lives. Calf mortality is relatively high among giraffes, as they are vulnerable to predators like lions, hyenas, and crocodiles during their early months. In captivity, where these animals are protected from many natural threats, giraffes may have a longer life expectancy. Some individuals have been known to live into their late 20s or 30s in well-managed captive environments. Not many predators will be able to tackle an adult giraffe, though old and sick individuals might be at risk from a lion or hyena. Far more worry comes from juvenile giraffes. Giving birth as a giraffe isn't easy, and after a 15-month gestation, the mother gives birth to a baby that can weigh up to 100 kilograms or 220 pounds and is immediately in danger. Young giraffes commonly fall prey to a wide range of dangerous animals, including leopards, wild dogs, lions, etc., so they've evolved to be able to stand within minutes of leaving the womb. This is the most vulnerable time for a giraffe, and many young will die at this stage. It's estimated that infant mortality is roughly 50%, a significant loss for such a lengthy gestation. For protection, giraffes typically live in herds of related females and their offspring, or bachelor herds of unrelated adult males. Individuals communicate, similar to elephants, with a series of sounds below the human audible threshold. These infrasounds allow giraffes to keep in touch through the ground or over vast distances. Some of their vocalizations can be heard and come out as a moo, grunt, or snort. All giraffes are considered the same species by the IUCN and are collectively listed as vulnerable and in decline. Populations are severely fragmented, and some are struggling more than others. Habitat loss remains the number one threat to giraffes, manifesting in the form of land conversion and deforestation. Civil unrest and illegal hunting play a significant role in their decline as well, but in many protected areas, giraffe populations are on the rise. As such large and iconic animals, giraffes are likely to receive widespread support for their conservation, yet their future remains uncertain. Giraffes are not considered one of the more dangerous animals on the savanna. They're generally calm animals and aren't all that threatened by humans. If they become uncomfortable, they tend to leave, so any altercation is unlikely. One woman was killed by a charging giraffe inside a game park in South Africa in 2023, but outside of this, it's hard to find any detailed account of a person even being attacked by a giraffe, let alone dying from the attack. That said, they are immense and powerful beasts, with kicks designed to incapacitate even a lion, so getting too close is ill-advised. Giraffes, as owners of the longest necks in the world today, stand tall on the savanna as exceptional, unique mammals, and are instantly recognizable on the plains. But this uniqueness came about relatively recently by evolutionary standards. Already, the species, or eight species, depending on who you ask, is in decline. Human development remains a global threat to wildlife, but with any luck, this iconic animal will get the support it needs to continue to thrive on the continent.